Hi there, welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we're talking about independent events. So let's start with something we've already learnt previously on Hegarty Maths. This is a standard question we've answered using sample spaces. Pause the video and double check you can do that. So hopefully you drew a sample space diagram and you got the following answers there. So the answers are there for you to check your work. So we're going to use this example to learn about something slightly different in this particular video. But before we do that, let's introduce the idea of independent events. So what are independent events in probability? Let's say events A and B are independent if the probability of either event occurring is not affected by the other event occurring. Now that's a bit of a mouthful, but it's basically to say that A is not affected in any way by B occurring, and B is not affected in any way by A occurring. So let me give you some questions to show you examples of A and B and to determine whether you think they're independent or not. Imagine A was the event that a flip coin lands on heads, and B was the event that a rolled dice lands on a six. Do you think they're independent? Well, I think they're independent. In no way does the flip coin affect the answer you get when you roll a dice. So they certainly are independent. A does not affect B and B does not affect A. What about this though? Let A be the event that it rains on Saturday, and let B be the event I go for a walk in the countryside on Saturday. Do you think they're independent or not? Well, in that case, I'd likely say they're not independent. The word for not independent, obviously, would be they are dependent. Now, if it rains on Saturday, it is likely to affect my decision of whether I go for that walk in the countryside or not. I may still go for the walk, it doesn't mean I won't go, but it might affect my decision and it will affect the probability of whether I go. So A happening does affect whether B happens there, so it seems like they might be dependent. So independent events, two events are independent if one doesn't affect the other. So going back to the previous example we just did about A rolling a dice and flipping a coin and answering those two questions we did using a sample space, there is actually another way to answer questions like that, and I want to show you here by some examples. Now, the probability of a tail and a 3 was 1 out of 12. Let me just point out to you that the probability of a tail getting a tail independently is a half, isn't it? And the probability of getting a 3 when you roll a dice is 1 out of 6. Now, can you see any link between a half and a six, those answers, and the overall answer we got for a tail and a 3 being a 12th? Well, it just so happens that a 12th is the probability of a tail, which is a half, multiplied by the probability of getting a 3, which is a 6th. So you get the same answer there. What about in this case? What was the probability of a head? Well, obviously, again, that's a half. What would be the probability of getting a prime number when you roll a dice? Well, the primes are 2, 3 and 5 out of a total of 6 outcomes, so that's 3 out of 6, which simplifies to a half. And again, the overall answer of a quarter could have been got by doing a half multiplied by a half. So it seems like in cases where events are independent, you can multiply each individual separate probability to get a combined probability of two things happening. So let's generalize that idea. Independent events. If events A and B are independent, then we can say that the probability of A and B occurring is just the probability of A multiplied by the probability of B. And there's a slightly different notation for that here. Here we're going to start using notation like that. This here means and in maths. Okay, or it means intersect. We'll deal more with the intersect meaning of it when we talk about sets, but a short way of writing the probability of A and B is A, this symbol, it's like an upside down U, B. Okay, so when events are independent, the probability of A and B is just the probability of A multiplied by the probability of B. So, using that idea, let's go on and answer some questions. Pause the video and have a go at this if you feel like you can. So Colin spins a fair spinner as shown, and he also flips a fair coin at the same time. What's the probability of getting a 3 and a head? Before we might have drawn a sample space diagram. Here we might use, because we're only answering one specific thing that we know the probabilities of each, we could just multiply the probabilities. So we could say the probability of getting a 3 is 1 out of 5. The probability of getting a head is 1 out of 2. So therefore the probability of a 3, and I'm going to use this sign here, and a head is simply a fifth multiplied by a half, which is 1 out of 10. And we would have got the same answer using the sample space diagram too. Okay, next question. Pause and have a go. So, we're told a card is drawn from a standard pack of cards and then a fair coin is flipped. What's the probability of an ace and a coin? So, landing on heads. So, the probability of an ace, well, looking at this diagram here, there are 4 aces out of a total of 52 cards. But we can see, we've talked about this previously, each card here is 1/13th of the pack. The aces are 1/13th of the pack. The twos are 1/13th of the pack. So, thinking in this way, the probability of an ace is 1/13th. Now, what's the probability of landing on a head? Well, the probability of a head is a half on a fair coin. So therefore, we can state that the probability of an ace and a head is going to be a 13th multiplied by a half. Multiplying those probabilities, 1 times 1 is 1. 13 times 2 is 26. That's our answer, 1/26. Next one, pause the video, have a go. So it says on a particular day, the probability of Brian buying a sandwich is 0.3 and the probability he gets on the bus is 0.8. Assuming the events are independent, what is the probability of Brian buying a sandwich and getting on a bus? We're told the events are independent so that we can multiply these probabilities here. So we want to work out that the probability of a sandwich and him getting on the bus, we're going to multiply these probabilities. The probability of him and buying a sandwich is 0.3 multiplied by the probability of him getting on the bus is 0.8. okay, and we should be able to do that quite simply. We do know that 3 multiplied by 8 is 24, so we would know that 0.3 multiplied by 8 must be 2.4, so we would know that 0.3 multiplied by 0.8 is 0.24, like that. So the answer is 0.24, and we're done. Okay, next one, pause the video, have a go. So this time a fair coin is flipped 3 times one after another. What is the probability of landing on heads 3 times in a row? So the only thing we know is the probability of a heads is simply a half. Now you want to work out the probability of a head and a head and another head, 3 heads in a row like that. Well, you're just going to multiply the probability of a head 3 times. So you're going to say that's a half multiplied by a half multiplied by a half, like that, which is 1 multiplied by 1 multiplied by 1 is 1, 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2 is 8. So it's simply an eighth, like that. Okay, last question, pause the video, have a go. So a fair dice is rolled 3 times in a row. What is the probability of first getting a 5, then any even number, and on the third roll a number less than 3? So let's write all these probabilities out. So the probability in the first case of getting a 5. What's the probability of getting a 5? Well, it is there is 1 5 out of 6 possible outcomes. Simple as that. Now, what's the probability of getting an even number? So let's just say even number. Well, there are 1, 2, 3 even numbers out of a total of 6. So it's 3 6, which simplifies to a half. And finally, what's the probability of getting on the third row a number less than 3? So less than 3. Well, how many numbers are less than 3? This one and this one. So it's 2 out of 6, which simplifies to a third. So if we want to work out the probability of getting a 5 and an even and less than 3, we're just going to multiply these probabilities. So we're going to do a 6 multiplied by a half multiplied by a third, like that. 1 multiplied by 1 multiplied by 1 is 1. 6 multiplied by 2 is 12. And 12 multiplied by 3 is 36. So the answer to that problem is a 36. And that's it for this video. Thanks loads for watching.